This is Srija. In this video, I will explain about basics of number systems and conversions from one system to another system. Okay. So basically, we have four types of number systems. First one is decimal. Second, binary. First, we should know about base of each number system. So, for decimal, base is 10. For binary, base is 2. For octal, base is 8. For hexadecimal, base is 16. That means each number we can represent by using 10 digits of decimal. For binary, we have only 2 digits. 2 digits means either 0 or 1. So, by using 0 and 1 only, we can represent any number in binary number system. So, in octal, we have base number is 8. So, 8 means 8 digits are there. So, 0, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. So, by using these 8 digits, we can represent any number in octal format. So, next we have hexadecimal number system. So, its base is 16. So, 16 in the sense, we have 16 digits, 0, 1, 2, and so on up to 9. So, from 10, we have A, B, C, D. So, A represents 10, B represents 11, C is 12, D is 13, E and F, 14, 15. So, from 0 to 15. So, up to 9 we have numbers. So, afterwards we have alphabets from A to F. So, by using these 16 digits, we can represent any number in hexadecimal format. So, in decimal we have only 10 digits from 0 to 9. So, by using 0 to 9, we can represent any number in decimal format. So, now I am going to explain about conversions from each number system. So, first consider decimal number system. Number conversions from decimal to binary. So now I am explaining about decimal number will be converted into binary. So for this I am considering decimal number as 15. So I have to convert 50 to binary. So for that purpose, just we have to divide this decimal number with base of binary number. So for binary, base is 2. So, we have to divide this 50 with 2. So, just 2 means 225 is 50. So, there is no remainder. So, 0. So, next 2, 12s, 24, 1 is left. So, next 2, 6, 12s, next 1 is 0. So, 2, 3, 6, there is no number left. So, 0. So, 2, 1 is 2. So, one number is left. So, next two zeros. So, here we one. Okay. So, from down to up, we can write a number. Okay. So, 1 1 0 0 1 0. So, this is the final binary number for 50. Okay. So, 50 in decimal. So, it is a binary representation of 50. Okay. So next I am explaining about binary to decimal. Okay, next conversion from binary to decimal. So again I am taking this value only. Just I am verifying this value to decimal. Okay. So consider binary number as 110010. So we have to convert this number to decimal number system. So for that purpose, for each and every digit, we have to multiply with base of binary. So that means powers of binary: 2 power 0, 2 power 1, 2 power 2, 2 power 3, 2 power 4, 2 power 5. So like that, we have to multiply each digit of binary with two powers. Okay, so finally we are getting decimal value. So from starting from right to left, just I am multiplying each digit with two powers. So I am writing directly 1 into 2 power 5 plus 1 into 2 power 4 plus 0 into 2 power 3 plus 0 into 2 power 2 plus 1 into 2 power 1 plus 0 into 2 power 0. So 0 into anything will be equal to 0. So finally, so 2 power 5 means 32, 2 power 4 means 16. 2 power 1 into 1 means 2, so total 50. So like that we can verify decimal to binary or binary to decimal. So this is the example for decimal to binary and binary to decimal conversion. So next I am converting decimal to octal, decimal number to octal conversion. So for octal, base is 8. So just again I am taking the value for decimal is 50 only. Okay, so this decimal number we can convert to octal. So for that purpose, just we are dividing this decimal number with base of octal. So base of octal is 8. Okay, so same like binary conversion, again we are dividing decimal number with base only. Okay, so 8 is 48, 2 is left. So next 8 zeros, 6 is left. So from bottom to top only we can write a number. So finally, octal number will be equal to 62. Okay, so decimal, 50 in decimal will be equal to 62 in octal. So again we need to verify whether it is correct or not. So for that purpose I am explaining about octal to decimal conversion. Okay, so again I am taking octal value as 62. So I am converting this octal value to decimal value, so it will be equal to 50 only. So one zero process for getting 50. Okay, so octal value is 62. So for converting octal to decimal, we have to multiply each digit of octal value into 8 powers. So because octal base is 8 only. Okay, so we have to multiply each digit with 8 powers. So 8 power 0, 8 power 1. Okay, so final decimal value equal to 8 power 1 into 6 plus 8 power 0 into 2. So 8 is 48 plus 2, that equal to 50. So both are verified. Okay, decimal to octal conversion, octal to decimal conversion is over. So next I will explain about decimal to hexadecimal. So decimal to hexadecimal, hexadecimal base is 16. Okay, so again I am taking same example, decimal value 50 only. Okay, for this 50 I am converting this 50 to hexadecimal. For that purpose, just we are dividing with base of hexadecimal, that is 16. 16 is 48, so 2 left. Next 16 zeros, 3 is left. So from bottom to top, hexadecimal value equal to 32. So decimal value 50 will be equal to 32 in hexadecimal. So we have to verify this hexadecimal value is correct or not. For that purpose I am converting hexadecimal to decimal again. Okay, so hexadecimal value I am taking 32. So we have to convert this 32 to decimal. For that purpose, each digit of hexadecimal is multiplying with 16 powers. 16 power 0, 16 power 1. So final decimal value will be equal to 16 power 1 into 3 plus 16 power 0 into 2, and equal to 16 3 is 48. 16 power 0 means 1 into 2, 2 total 50. So both are verified, decimal to hexadecimal conversion and hexadecimal to decimal conversion. So all conversions over. Next, binary to octal representation. So next I am explaining about binary to octal representation. So for that purpose I am taking binary value. This one, okay? 11100010. So we have to convert this binary number to octal. So we need to know base of octal, that is 8. So 8 means in terms of binary, 8 will be written as 2 power 3. So as per this 2 power 3, just we are dividing given binary number into groups. Okay, in each group 3 digits are there. Okay, so like that binary number, we have to divide binary number into 3 values as a group. Okay, so just convert each group into decimal. Okay, so convert each group into decimal, then we will get final octal value. Okay, so 010 means 2, 110 means 62. So this is the answer for converting binary to octal. Okay, this is the process. First, given binary number, we have to divide this given binary number into 2 groups. Okay, so in each group 3 digits should be there. So we have to divide each group, we have to convert each group to binary, decimal. Okay, final value will be octal only. So next, binary to hexadecimal conversion. Again I am taking binary value as 110010. So here the base for hexadecimal is 16. So this 16 will be written in terms of 2 power, that is 4, 2 power 4. So again for this conversion, we have to divide given binary number into 4 digits as a part. Okay, first 4 digits as a part, remaining digits as a part. Okay, here we can keep zeros. Okay, so again we have to convert these groups into decimal number. Okay, so 0010 means 2, 0011 means 32. So 32 in hexadecimal, it is the value for this conversion, 32. So binary to octal is over, binary to hexadecimal is also over. So next conversion is octal to hexadecimal. So octal to hexadecimal. So in octal I am taking the value as 62. So octal I am taking value as 62. So for converting octal to hexadecimal, first we have to convert octal to binary, then from binary to hexadecimal we have to take. Okay, so first convert octal to binary. So octal base is 8, so it can be written as 2 power 3. So for this octal to binary conversion, for each digit we have to represent it into binary as 3 digits. Okay, so 2 means 010, 0 means 011. So like that we have to convert octal to binary. So again we need to convert this binary to hexadecimal, because finally we want value in terms of hexadecimal. So for that purpose we need to convert this binary to hexadecimal. So binary to hexadecimal means just again we have to divide each this number into 4 digits as a group. Okay, so keep zeros in empty places. So 1010 means